This is the FineView Pro dashboard camera, better known as a blackbox. Now, as you guys already know, I record everything. You know, it's for my protection, for the members' protection, and whatever I see what's going on in the street. So I got this dash camera because I need a dedicated dash cam. You know, my GoPro wasn't a dedicated camera. And I need something to record all the time on a loop. Now, the GoPro can do that, but it's not as stable as this FineView. Now, if I hadn't said it once, I'll say it again. This is the FineView Pro dash cam. I got it from Amazon. It was $199. I got the lens cap. I don't need to go into all that because you guys already seen the unbox video when I got it. This particular video right here is what I'm doing right here is to let you guys see how it is. I mean, this what you're seeing is being recorded. It's at nighttime. I'm doing the GPS unit. You know, keeps track of my miles. Right now, I'm doing between 65 and 64, or 64 and 65. Speed limit is 65. I'm going down 90. So what this little camera could do, I'm digging it. I mean, it's a witness. You guys need that. I mean, you get in an accident, something happened. It's that video witness that you need, or that I need. You know, car accidents. As a matter of fact, I was in a car accident about a month ago. 2 months after I just brought my truck, a lady came and sideswiped me. Now, unfortunately for me, I didn't even win the case or win the liability because it was a case of he say, she say. She said I ran the red light. I said she ran the red light. Cop says he don't know who's right because he wasn't there. Her insurance is not covering for my damages. So I had to go through my insurance to get it done. So I said, at that time, I said, well, you know, I had my GoPro camera, and if I would have had it hooked up, I probably would have got it. But unfortunately, I didn't. Like I said, it's not a dedicated dash camera, you know. So now I went online, I did a lot of homework. I went into dashcam.com forums, YouTube videos. There's a lot of dashcam YouTube videos. Let me see, Reddit, there's a dedicated dashcam video on that website. YouTube, forums, and I just sort of all over the internet. Now, it was one from this company called Z-tronics that I was about to pull the trigger on that one, but like I said, I went into the forums and I, you know, started reading and, you know, doing my homework, and now I came across this company called FineView. Now, it was a toss-up between FineView and another company called blackbox. Both of them, you can Google both of them, and it'll bring up the necessary information that you need to know about them two particular cameras. Now, the blackbox is a little bit better than what I got. You know, it's a little bit smaller, it's tubular size, and it records in 1080p. At 30 frames per second. Now, I'm not a big per second buff, or I'm not even going to begin to even understand what that stuff is. But from what I gather, the frame rate is like, you know, like it's a little bit smooth. I got this camera right here. It's set at 900p at 30 frames per second. The 1080p on here is 15 frames per second. So it's a little bit jerky. It's a little bit jerky, but I toned it down because I said, I mean, I'm going to upload it to YouTube, you know, so I guess, you know, the video doesn't make a difference on YouTube, you know, whether the quality or not. And it's not like I'm going to put this on my home theater and say, hey, you know, check out this driving video that I did, you know. I'm not going to do that. Besides, I watch the majority of my videos on my laptop anyway, so the video looked just, you know, just about crystal clear than as if it was a 1080p. So that's the difference between the black view and the fine view, is because the 1080p setting, one is at 15 frames per second and the other one at 30 frames per second. So, but back to this black box that I got, it's pretty cool. I mean, it has all of the pieces together, the fine view, the GPS unit, and the polarized cap. Shouldn't cost you no more. It should cost you a little under $300 altogether. I got the, at first I wasn't going to get the GPS unit, but like I said, reading the forums, they said that it's not necessary, but it's best to have. So, they doing some road work over here on 990. But, like I said, I went back and I got it. I got it from Amazon. It was free shipping on this one. It was $30, you know, $30. So altogether, $199, rounded up to $200. Polar cap was about $30. So about $260 and some change. So like I said, it's a pretty good camera. It does what it's supposed to do. It has three modes. It has normal recording modes, which records in 3-minute segments. It comes with a 16 gig memory card. Now the memory card, I upgraded it from 15 to 32. But 16 is adequate. It takes maybe about 4 days worth of video before it starts recording over the old stuff. The 32 records maybe about 8 days of video before it starts looping. Parking mode. That's the mode that you have to have the camera constantly working in order for parking mode to work. Parking mode, it records what it says. When you park, it'll go into parking mode, and anything that comes across the screen, coming across the lens, it starts recording, and that records in 1-minute settings. That records in 1 minute set. And that's pretty cool when you're parked in a shopping center or something like that, and you get those people that bump up against your car, you know, those bump and runs, you know, that just happen to bump your car and take off, and you come back out from the store and you notice a new scratch or a new dent on your car, and you'd be like, who the hell did that? Now that you got the camera, you can tell. But unfortunately, you can't tell from the side, you know, or you can't tell from the back. Now, I'm thinking later down the line, I might get the black view for the record in the back as a two-channel type deal. But back to this. You record, it's a shock sensor, so when somebody do bump into your car, it starts to record, and that records in 1 minute segment. Also, it has, let me see, park, normal, and event. So, let's say you're driving, and you come up on this particular situation, and you say to yourself, like, hey, that's something I might want to keep right quick, you know? Or a big crash or something like that. You hit the button right quick, and it starts, that starts recording in 1 minute then. So, when you go to your computer, when you hook this up to your computer in the USB mode, you'll see the files broken into different file increments on your computer. And that's where the videos will be located. So your day-to-day, your day-to-day local normal videos will be in one file. Your motion videos will be in another file. And your shock videos will be in the event file, as well as the emergency mode when you push the button. What else about this? Oh, you can turn the microphone on and off, on or off. You can do a lot. So there's not too much to say about this camcorder. It's for anybody, especially if you travel a lot, I will recommend it. If you're a person that works, that works on the road like myself, it's recommend to have. You know, it's that third eyewitness that you need for any case that happens. And like I said, I'm thinking about getting the black view because it's small. And it can record straight out the back window. So it will record everything in the back, record everything. I have this record everything in the front. Alright guys, well this is, like I said, it's me, Lockout Man. You can check me out on my YouTube channel. That's YouTube. Yeah, see right here? Right here? Bam! You see that? Right there's what I'm talking about. Right there, craziness, right there, that's what I'm talking about. Look at this dude, see what I'm saying? He don't know what he want to do, so that's what I'm talking about. You guys see it with me, we just caught it together, but that's what I'm saying. My YouTube channel, YouTube.com/GStyle23. Make sure you guys comment. If you guys have any questions for me, I always answer all questions on my channel, no matter what. Excuse me. I answer all my questions, no matter what. Subscribe to me. Because you never know when I put up a video or something, either from this or my GoPro. What else? Oh, check out my other videos. I got another channel called ERS Lockout. Now, I rarely upload videos to that because I'm constantly uploading videos to my G-Style channel, so, but still check that out. I mean, I still have some videos on there that might be of interest. Like I said, if you guys have any questions or anything like that, just give me a holler, and I'll feel free to ask. I mean, answer them. All right, guys. I'm going to go ahead and stop talking and let my video take over. Continue videotaping. And I'll get back with you guys later. Holler at your boy. Lock out, man.
I'm still on you, my drink's still on me, while I'm still on you.